TimesDaily.com, the only portal for news from India, UK, Canada, Punjab and Gujarat. In English, Punjabi and Gujarati, with a list of well-established businesses and resources that you may need. I'm Prerna Sharma and today's headlines are... In India, the Congress has accused Prime Minister Narendra Modi of playing politics on national security issues. And PDP President Mehbooba Mufti has hailed the Kartarpur Corridor initiative. In UK, a British academic has been pardoned by the UAE. And Prime Minister Theresa May has warned MPs to back her deal or risk division. In Punjab, Chief Minister Amrinder Singh has blamed Pakistan over terror attacks in the state. And thousands of Sikh pilgrims from the world over have gathered at Pakistan's Gurdwara Panja Sahib. Stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com and I'll be back with all the news that's important for you from India, UK and Punjab. For detailed news and business updates of the Indo-UK community, download the Indian Times Daily app. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from India are... The Congress has hit back at Prime Minister Narendra Modi after he criticised the party on issues of terrorism and Naxalism. The Congress alleged that he was playing politics on matters of national security. Modi has said that the Congress, which was in power when 26/11 Mumbai attacks took place, had questioned the BJP government's surgical strikes in Pakistan. PDP President Mehbooba Mufti has said that instead of violence and bloodshed, the Kashmir problem can be resolved through Kartarpur-like initiatives. By taking the decision of opening the Kartarpur corridor, country's leadership has exhibited statesmanship. That too when electoral exercise is on, she added. Sunil Arora has been appointed the new Chief Election Commissioner by President Ramnath Kovind, sources said on Monday. He will take over from O.P. Rawat on December 2nd. A former bureaucrat, Arora was appointed to the election body in September last year. 8 Naxals and 2 police personnel have been killed in an encounter between ultras and security men in Chhattisgarh Sukma district. The gun battle took place when a team of security personnel was out on an anti-Naxal operation. The government will pump 42,000 crore rupees into debt-laden public sector banks in the remainder of the current financial year to March. This will be done with an aim to improve their financial health. The CBI has procured the requisite sanction to prosecute former Union Minister P. Chidambaram in the Airtel Maxis case. The court, however, has extended till December 18 the protection granted to Chidambaram and his son Karthi from arrest. A passenger on board a Jet Airways Kolkata-Mumbai flight has been arrested after a fellow passenger heard him using words like terrorist and destroy over the phone. Yog Vedanta Poddar, a resident of Kolkata, was forced to leave on. Despite barely 10 days to go for the December 7th elections in Telangana, major political parties are yet to formally release their manifestos. However, they have been sparing no effort to look more magnanimous than others by making tall promises through political speeches. India has achieved a new spot on the Guinness World Records. This is after 2,353 people, led by Bollywood actor and fitness enthusiast Shilpa Shetty Kundra, held the abdominal plank position for 60 seconds simultaneously. The record was earlier held by China. Akshay Kumar, who features as the antagonist in the much-awaited high-budget Entertainer 2.0, went through an elaborate prosthetic makeup process for his character. The actor says that it was quite a test of his patience that it had calmed him down. Stay tuned to Indian Times Daily as news from UK and Punjab follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from UK are: A British academic who was jailed for spying in the UAE has been freed after a pardon. Matthew Hedges, aged 31, denied spying and said that he had been researching his PhD. Foreign Secretary Jeremy Hunt said that the government had never seen any evidence that the spying charges were true. Prime Minister Theresa May has warned MPs to oppose her plan that rejecting the Brexit deal will be risky and lead to division and uncertainty. May's common speech comes after the 27 other EU leaders approved the terms of the UK's exit at a summit. A piece of art inspired by an actor's on-stage pose will be the UK's largest cast bronze sculpture when it goes on display next year. The 23-foot sculpture called Messenger will be installed outside the Theatre Royal Plymouth. 3 tons of hashish with a street value of millions of pounds has been seized in the Gulf. The Royal Navy warship HMS Dragon was on patrol in the Middle East in a drug smuggling route known as the Hash Highway when it came across the suspicious boat. A sacked Welsh government minister found dead at his home last year left a letter telling his family, "I failed you." Labour AM Carl Sargeant was found hung 4 days after First Minister Carwin Jones dismissed him as Communities and Children's Secretary. The Bank of England has released a list of scientists who have been nominated to feature on the new £50 note. The list comprises of computing pioneers Alan Turing and Ada Lovelace, telephone inventor Alexander Graham Bell and astronomer Patrick Moore. A Labour MP accused of lying about who was driving her speeding car will face a retrial after a jury failed to reach a verdict. Fiona Onasanya is alleged to have claimed that a Russian man was behind the wheel to escape prosecution for driving 41 miles per hour in a 30 miles per hour zone in July 2017. The Swansea University has suspended its Vice Chancellor Professor Richard B. Davies, who had held the role at the university since 2003 for an internal investigation to be carried out. The Dean of the School of Management, Professor Mark Clement, and two other staff members have also been suspended. A South African rugby player's ticking alarm clock caused a bomb scare that led to the team hotel being evacuated. The incident took place on the eve of the Springboks 2011 defeat to Wales, with the hotel saying that a suspicious package was found in a player's room. A pop singer who had toured with Little Mix has been jailed for killing a cyclist in a road crash. Nadine Samuels, part of a girl band called M.O., did not stop her blue Ford KA after hitting straight into Debbie Mills, who suffered brain injuries and died in the hospital. I'll be back. Stay logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Punjab follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from Punjab are: Chief Minister Amrinder Singh has hit out at Pakistan Army Chief General Qamar Javed Bajwa, blaming him for terror activities in the state and killings of Indian soldiers at the border. Singh also warned Pakistan over its terror activities. Sikh pilgrims from all over the world have poured into Gurdwara Panjra Sahib in Pakistan's Punjab province to celebrate the 549th birthday anniversary of Guru Nanak. Over 3,800 Indian Sikh pilgrims, 148 from UK, and thousands of Sikh and Hindu devotees from Pakistan visited the Gurdwara. Chief Minister Amrinder Singh has sought the intervention of Union Minister for Road Transport and Highways Nitin Gadkari for the expeditious clearance of road projects in the state. Most of the road pertain to the town of Sultanpur Lodi, Batala and Dera Baba Nana. Pakistan's Information and Broadcasting Minister Fawad Chaudhry has said that the Kartarpur Corridor project is a step that proves Islamabad wants peace. The statement came ahead of groundbreaking ceremony by Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan on November 28. A number of politicians, including Haryana Chief Minister Manohar Lal Khattar, have visited Divya Jyoti Jagriti Sansthan at Noor Mahal for a spiritual program. Hundreds of Ashutosh Maharaj's followers and disciples also took part in the program. Malaysian humanitarian aid worker Rishibhan Singh Riandhwa, also known as the Flying Sikh, has died in a road accident in Patiala. Randhwa was a member of the United Sikh Malaysia Humanitarian Aid Organization. The Khanna police have recovered 1.5 kg heroin worth 7.5 crore rupees in the international market by arresting a Nigerian national. The accused was caught while descending from a bus that was coming from Chandigarh. A study has revealed that drug abuse has been most rampant in border districts of Tarantaran and Amritsar. Since the state launched outpatient opioid-assisted treatment clinics for addicts last year, Tarantaran and Amritsar recorded the maximum number of patients enrolled in clinics. Parallel Tak Jathedars and other Panthik leaders, as well as hardliners, have given a call to form a new Akali Dal to transform the religious and political scenario in Punjab. The leaders have also urged all like-minded Panthik political parties to join hands. India's batting star Harmanpreet Kaur has been named captain of ICC Women's World T20 11, which also featured opener Smriti Manthana and leg spinner Poonam Yadav. Harmanpreet is a Moga-born Punjabi who has won several awards, including the prestigious Arjuna Award. This is the end of the news bulletin, but stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Bollywood is coming up next. And do visit the resources section on this portal to find the best Indo-UK businesses and resources, accounting firms to wedding planners in your city. All of us at Indian Times Daily wish that you have a great day.
Actor Aamir Khan, who is an active member of the social media, leaves no stone unturned in sharing unforgettable moments with his family to the world. Indeed, Aamir and his wife Kiran are doting parents of their son Azad Rao, as their lives revolves around their son only, and the trio makes a very cute family. Recently, Amir revived his childhood days by hosting an Asterix theme party for his son Azad. Amir took his Twitter handle and shared a series of photos where Azad was dressed as Asterix, Amir as Obelix, and Kiran as Getafix. Well, aren't they looking cute? On work front, Amir's latest outing was Tugs of Hindustan, which released during the Diwali weekend this year. The film was directed by Vijay Krishna Acharya and also starred Amitabh Bachchan, Katrina Kaif, and Fatima Sana Sheikh in the lead roles. After Deepika Ranveer's wedding, now it's time to talk about Priyanka Chopra and her American singer beau Nick Jonas' wedding, which will take place in Jodhpur in December. The duo was spotted in Delhi, where a pre-wedding party for Priyanka and Nick was organized on the sets of her upcoming film, The Sky is Pink. Love, laughter and happily ever after to the beautiful bride-to-be. Read a post on the official Twitter handle on Roy Kapoor Films, which is producing the movie. The cake reads, "Congratulations to our dear bride-to-be, PCJ." Now fulfilling her work commitments, PC arrived in Mumbai with Nick Jonas. The duo got a warm welcome from their fans. The couple also waved as the shutterbug snapped them. Indeed, both of them were looking adorable together. Priyanka's mother Madhu Chopra was recently in Jodhpur to overlook. Preparations have been on in full swing, but the wedding dates have not been officially announced yet.
Actor Abhishek Bachchan on Sunday said voiceover for the Indianized version of English movie Mowgli, The Legend of the Jungle has been challenging and liberating. Netflix India launched the Indian version trailer of Mowgli in the presence of filmmaker, director and actor Andy Serkis, along with original voiceover cast Christian Bale, Frida Pinto and Rohit Chand, and Indian dubbing team which includes Abhishek Bachchan, Kareena Kapoor Khan, Madhuri Dixit and Anil Kapoor. Talking about voicing Black Panther Bagheera, Abhishek Bachchan said the whole experience was very challenging as well as liberating. The Manmarzia actor said,
"It was very, very challenging. What was liberating about this entire exercise is, I think for the first time, in our films, in our industry, there is a huge element of your personality that you always bring to a character, which is probably not prevalent in the West. In Indian cinema, that's almost a prerequisite. What was nice is you got liberated because you got to be an entirely new character and you weren't confined within those boundaries."
Transition of language was equally challenging, said the Dostana actor, adding,
"What was really nice is, I wasn't playing a human being, so that was new. And keeping that in mind and keeping the way Mr. Serkis had designed the character, the way, you know, Christian had performed it, and then to try and Indianize it, that was very challenging. Also, to fit linguistically Hindi into an English dialogue is very challenging. They're two completely separate languages which have a different tone, a different meter. So that was challenging."
The Netflix version of Rudyard Kipling's The Jungle Book is darker and edgier than releases of its previous versions. Mowgli, The Legend of the Jungle will release on 7 December. Hrithik Roshan wrote an emotional post to his closest friend and ex-wife Suzanne Khan that talks about their undivided bond. The estranged couple Hrithik Roshan and Suzanne are often seen going on a holiday together with their kids and even on dinner and movie outing during the weekends. Hrithik took to his Instagram page and shared a heartfelt post for Suzanne, which is further read. "Here is Suzanne, my closest friend, capturing a moment with me and our boys. A moment in itself, it tells a story to our kids that in a world separated by lines and ideas, it is still possible to be united and that you can want different things as people and yet stay undivided. Here's to a more united, tolerant, brave, open and loving world. It all starts at home." Hrithik and Suzanne had got married in 2000 after a prolonged fairy tale love story. The couple has two sons, Hiran and Hridan. They separated in December 2013 and the divorce was finalized in November 2014. Meanwhile, on work front, Hrithik will be seen playing the role of an ace mathematician named Anand Kumar in Super 30. The film is slated to release on 25th January 2019. Apart from that, Hrithik also has an action film with Tiger Shroff, which is being helmed by Siddharth Anand.
After making a comeback Earlier this year, with Viredi Wedding, Bollywood diva Kareena Kapoor Khan making bold fashion statements in an event from the last few days. Bebo, who gave her voice for the upcoming web film Mowgli, Legend of the Jungle, recently attended the trailer launch of the web film and once again made our jaws drop with her sexy attire. Kareena was seen wearing a black strappy maxi dress with a plunging neckline. After that, at the screening of the web film, Bebo once again proved that she is the ultimate style queen. The lady wore a shimmery off-shoulder high-slit dress with matching heels. She was all smiles for the shutterbox. Also, Kareena stole everyone's heart in white sari when she honored at an award function by Vice President Venkaiah Naidu. The event was also saw Kartik Aaryan, Ayushmann Khurrana, Apar Shakti Khurrana, Zara Wasim and Sunil Grover. On film front, Kareena has some good projects in her kitty. The actress is all set to share the screen space with Akshay Kumar and Diljit Dosanjh starrer Good News. She will also be seen in Karan Johar's Takht with Ranveer Singh, Vicky Kaushal, Bhoy Pednekar, Janvi Kapoor and Arjun Kapoor.